So you're familiar with Earth coordinates, of course, where latitude tells you your angle from the equator, and your longitude tells you your angle from the prime meridian. And on the celestial sphere, there are equivalents for this latitude and longitude measurement. Those are called declination, right ascension. So declination is the same as latitude on the celestial sphere, measured from the equator up. So exactly the same way as latitude on Earth, except measured from the celestial instead of the Earth's equator. And then right ascension is angle on the celestial sphere, and it's measured actually from the location of the sun during March equinox. And that's not this quite the same as longitude, because longitude is measured from the prime meridian, which passes through Greenwich, England. And right ascension, the 0 point for that does not pass through the prime meridian. Starry night, and also the simulations that I have taken images from today, measure right ascension in terms of time. So there's a full 24 hours of right ascension going all the way around the celestial sphere. You can look at your coordinates in the celestial sphere from the perspective of the sphere, but that's not very convenient for an observer on the Earth. So for an observer, we tend to use what we call horizon coordinates. And for these, we have altitude, which is kind of like, again, latitude. And this is just the angle that a star is above your horizon. So it can vary from 0 to 90. And then the azimuth is the angle around the horizon. And again, this is different from right ascension and declination. It's measured from north, and it becomes larger as you move eastward. So for the North Star Polaris, what would be the declination and altitude as seen from Eugene? So the Polaris is actually marked here. So I put one star up here at the north celestial pole. So that's our pole star Polaris. And you can notice that it is at 90 degrees from the celestial equator. So its declination is definitely 90 degrees. And then if we look back to our horizon coordinates, I also have Polaris marked here. And let's see, a way to think about the connection between these two diagrams is to notice the two colors of the lines that we're using. So we have this yellow line you can kind of see here going from east to west. And then there's another yellow line here that's connecting our north and south. Let's see. So one of these yellow lines is our celestial equator, right? So if I now look at my observer view one more time, you can see this celestial equator, and that's going to be tilted from our horizon by an amount equivalent to our latitude, right? Which is about 45 degrees. So then the altitude of the star, of the North Star, also ends up being about 44 degrees.